Hi, Matt.
Hey, how's it going, man?
Good. This is your second time to do the interview with us.
But first time in person.
Yeah,
so it's great to meet you.
Yeah. You did a good job to kick off the Billboard Hot 100 Fest, actually.
Thank you, man. Thank you. Yeah. You know, I love the beach stage. It's one of my favorite venues. It's always great in terms of getting a crowd to dance to, and I was happy that we had a great crowd for it. Yeah.
Wow. And how long you prepare for this year? Because this is your second time perform for the Billboard Hot 100.
Actually, my third time, but my first time was under a different name. I used to DJ as Sakari, so I'm actually the only artist to have played three times.
Wow.
Crazy, right?
It feels like home. The stage is your home. It's so come I, back your home.
And I will say that I felt comfortable because I knew the festival, but you know I definitely prepared and I feel really fortunate that there were a great number of fans that came out to support me.
It's been a year since you spoke to our DJ Doom Kitty last year. So what happened in the last 12 months?
The most significant thing, I suppose, would be that I was promoted at Billboard. Mm-hmm. So my new role is Director Dance Electronic Programming and Cross-Department Content Strategy, which is a long way of saying that I'm still the head of Billboard Dance, but I'm also helping apply some of the strategies that we use to build it to some of the other verticals as well. And I think there are so many exciting things that Billboard, the flagship, and Billboard Dance are doing to continue to consolidate our position at the top and at the forefront of music. Billboard Dance, we've never had a stronger team. Mm. As I mentioned, Dave came on board as sort of like my right-hand man. Kat Bine is our go-to writer. She's been fantastic. And Jordan Diaz joined as a producer in the LA office for Billboard THR News, and he contributed for Dance before, and we have someone who's really helping with video out there. So, you know, I remember when I started this thing, and it was literally just me, and I was the only person that liked it. And
like
now,
a one-man show.
It was a one-man show. Yeah. Obviously, I've got great support from our social team.
Yeah.
Stephanie, Mira. You know, there have been so many people have helped.
Because last year you talked a little bit about how DJing is an access in empathy.
Yeah.
And the ways in which you connect with different audience. In different ways. So how have you been connecting with audience over the last year, both through your music, but also through Billboard Dance?
That's a really great question. It's a really great question. It's a multifaceted question. I would say, so I've always, you know, I've said this before, but I'll make sure that it's very clear. You know, I see my DJing and my music, my artist project, my music career, as an extension of my role as the curator of Billboard Dance. So I started Billboard Dance because I loved sharing new music mm-hmm. with a wide population. I never wanted to preach to the masses. I always wanted to show people something new.
Yep.
You know, that's why we were early to guys like Kygo and Marshmello and all that. We were just like, look.
Yeah, we saw that. Yeah. You filled up that.
Yeah. Well, thank you. Yeah. I you know what? Like, it wasn't just me, but we played a big role. We played a big role. And I'm really, I feel like that's where my passion lies in curating. When I heard Kygo's music for the first time, I was like, this kid's gonna be huge. So I gave him a Billboard feature when he had never played outside Norway. And Marshmello, I worked really closely with his manager to help make that, you know, like we worked together on that because I believed in the project.
Cool.
And so I would say that to answer your question, that curation mm-hmm. side, that passion for finding new artists that I think could resonate with a wide population is something that I also try to apply. Obviously, I apply it every day at Billboard Dance, but I also try and apply it to my own music. If you go see me DJ, it'll probably be a lot of songs you maybe haven't heard before.
Mm-hmm.
And, you know, that's something that I'm really intentional about because I want to give those songs a platform.
We asked you this a year ago. Now it's time to ask you again. What is next for Matt Matfield and the Billboard Dance?
Well, I see Billboard Dance continuing to lead the charge for dance music publishing globally. I think that we have made incredible strides over the past year. I think that I'm very happy with where we're at, but I am not satisfied because I want us to be a truly global brand. When I started Billboard Dance, I said, I understand that Billboard are, you know, it's the US charts, but yep. I never wanted to be a US specific publication. I see Billboard Dance as a global brand, and I see Billboard Dance as a place for everyone. Now that we have an even stronger team, now that we have some very ambitious new projects, which you'll hear about as soon as I'm ready, I'll make sure
you got it. Yeah.
Wish you all the best.
Thank you, man.
Wish you all the best.
Well. Thank you for always being so supportive.
Yeah, and I see you next time.
Absolutely. Maybe next time in China.
Sure. Why not? Yeah.
I would love to go.
Make a plan.
It's been too long. I'm overdue for a visit.
Okay.